Hey guys, welcome back to some more American Truck Simulator. I am Boo78, and this is my ATS Let's Play series, Stories of the Road. I upload this every Tuesday and Thursday. Hope you guys are doing well today. We are here in Eureka, California, still in the Kenworth T680. We are at Walbert, getting ready to pick up our load, going down to, take a look here real quick. We're going down to Santa Cruz with this load of ice cream. Go ahead and confirm our job, and we'll get all started and hooked up here. And you're probably wondering why you guys are not seeing the finished trip up here to Eureka. Yeah, funny story there. I was finishing it up yesterday. Hop in the cab here. Finished recording it yesterday, or so I thought I finished recording it yesterday. I mean, I played it, but once I got done, kind of realized that I forgot to start recording it with OBS. Recorded my audio like I always do with Audacity, because I get a lot better audio quality with Audacity than I do straight out of OBS. So yeah, a little bit of a noob error on my part. Pull up just a skosh. Straightened out here, which I was kind of disappointed, because it was a really good run, and I've not made it up, you know, I've not traveled north on 101 a whole lot, and it was just a really, really nice scenic trip. And now we overcorrected too far on the other side, so let's see if we can't split the difference and go right down the middle. Should just be able to pull up here a little bit, and we should be able to. There we go. Get all coupled up here. Hop outside, take a look. Yeah, this is just a really good looking combo. You know, I'm typically not a fan of the trailers with the side skirts, the aero skirts, whatever you want to call them. But, you know, when you have an aero truck like this, I think it really comes together pretty nice and just looks real nice and clean, and just really, really like it. Yep. Brakes are working good. So we can head down south to Santa Cruz. Hopefully later this week I can sit down and get some modding done on a couple trucks, maybe this weekend. Just haven't had a whole lot of time here lately. But just been real busy outside the YouTube community, outside all my gaming and stuff like that. All really good stuff. Why this does this, I do not know. Man. I don't know why that does that. I don't think it's anything in the settings. Unless I hit that just right, it does not want to split into the next set of gears. Very strange indeed, yes? Yes. Thank you. Big old Western Great Dane spread axle there. Another red light up here, so I'm not going to try splitting the gears just yet. See, as of this recording, I do not have the mod spreadsheet updated yet. That's not to say by the time it goes live it won't be updated, so be sure to check it out. But what I'm trying to do there is get that updated, then I'm gonna add a column as to you know, what game version I'm on and if it's compatible with that version. There's I haven't got the stuff added yet, but I seen the other day, it looks like Jazzy Cat has a whole bunch of new traffic AI stuff out there that is compatible with 1.4. So I want to get some of that stuff in game. Don't want to put a whole lot of it in game because I don't want to take a chance of, you know, huge frame rate drops and stuff like that. Unless it's not going to affect frame rates at all, then by all means, I'll put that stuff in there. So if any of you guys have used his stuff in the past, let me know if it's affected your performance at all. And if it has not, then I will definitely get some more of that stuff in the game. Yeah, as I was coming through here the other day, man, I just love the scenery up through here. All the big trees and everything. This looks really great. You know, this fast became one of my favorite spots, you know, in the game. Extremely scenic. Nice green, lush scenery. This looks really, really good. Plus, you know, that's a little bit hilly here, so, you know, it's not extremely challenging to drive through, but, you know, you do have to drop a couple gears here and there, which is, you know, kind of neat, kind of immersive, so kind of like that. But some of that Jazzy Cat stuff I was talking about, looks like he has one AI pack that is like, looks like company trucks. So you'll have, you know, like CRST trucks pulling CRST trailers and stuff like that, which I think is really cool. I tried that back in the day in Holland and just had zero luck with it. You know, instead of just having, you know, plain old AI trucks pulling, you know, this trailer, that trailer, whatever, you know, you could potentially see, you know, if, you know, it was something that was in there, you know, but kind of for an example, you could see, you know, a Western, you know, distributing company combo and the AI traffic, which is, you know, be pretty cool. Just kind of raises that immersion factor and just, you know, makes the game a little bit more satisfying. Low as we go through all these hills and everything. Yeah, look at the mountains up there. That's just really nice looking. Really, really nice looking. A lot of stuff to get to this week. As I'm recording this stuff, I'm going to record Tuesday's episode of Stories from the Road and Thursday, so I'll get all that knocked out of the way today, get all that stuff edited today. And then I got a couple other ATS videos I'd like to get to this week. Got to finish up the video settings tutorial. I'll talk a little bit about that the last episode. Just basically going to show you guys my settings and, you know, hopefully give you guys some tips that will help you gain a couple frames, maybe help you get a little bit better FPS, and then kind of give a quick guide on how to use NVIDIA Inspector. I know a lot of people out there use it. Some people kind of don't have a whole lot of experience with it, so hopefully show you guys how to use that, and like I said, just help you hopefully get some better performance in game and make your game look a little bit better, run a little bit better, and we'll kind of put a quick disclaimer out there, though, that results will vary with this. But yeah, we'll do it, take a look at it, and hopefully it helps. And still want to get a news update video out to you guys. I know they released some screenshots last week of some updated pictures of the map rescale. They just gave a real brief, vague update like they typically do, which is okay, I guess. About, you know, it sounds like they're a little bit ahead of schedule on the rescale project. Potentially a few weeks out from some internal beta testing. So hopefully that's the case, because typically, you know, the internal beta testing means it's only a few weeks away from the beta going live, so. I'm not sure if I turned off citations or whatever, but yeah, I have not been getting like any tickets or anything. I just looked down, I was going like 65. I'm surprised we didn't get flagged for that. I'm gonna set the cruise right there at 60. And I like how now, as soon as I hit the cruise, something popped up there in the middle of the dash that says my cruise is set at 60, so that's pretty cool. Finally getting around to getting LSPDFR installed here on the new computer. Come on, car, get over. All you had to do was get over in the left-hand lane. All that could have been avoided. So I'm just waiting for the speed limit to change here. I'd imagine it's going to change here any second. Maybe, maybe not. Son of a gun. About killed the truckster. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is part of the MHA map, and I'm pretty sure I have not traveled through here before. If I have, it's been a while and I really don't remember it, but this is pretty freaking sweet. This is definitely some, you know, the stuff that I'd like to see more of, you know, in-game. You know, give us this, you know, these hilly, mountainous roads. And stuff to drive on, you know, in the areas that are supposed to be kind of hilly and mountainous. Sunset over there. At least it kind of looks like it a little bit, I guess. And hopefully this is something they fix in the rescale, because this is like the craziest section of the map, hands down. I mean, I don't know of any toll booths out there that you can drive, you know, 60, 70 mile an hour through. I'm surprised I don't get into more accidents here than I do. Couldn't avoid that. Could not have avoided that. Let's just, yeah, we, you know, kind of ran over a car up here, sorry. Eventually be able to go, or what the deal is. That's just one of those cases where, you know, speed limit goes from this to that in the blink of an eye with no warning or anything like that. Some kind of advance warning on stuff like that would be kind of nice. You know, some kind of prompt or whatever on the screen that says, hey, you know, reduce speed, 30 mile an hour zone just ahead. Something real basic, you know. got to be getting pretty close. I guess not. We're just about there. See anyone coming, so we should be able to go right on red here. This thing gonna... Are you kidding me? How can this thing not make it up this hill? Oh my God. Physics in this game. This is freaking ridiculous. We're just gonna roll down the hill, you know, whatever. This thing's only like 43,500 pounds. I'm just gonna leave him first. Whatever. Why I would be going through downtown San Francisco anyway, instead of, you know, just driving on the interstate and taking a bypass. But it is what it is, I guess. Not much you can do about it. Yes, I'm just running through all the stop signs because I'm not going to take a chance of this thing dying again like that, because that was just stupid. This one. I wish I would have looked at my map, because I probably could have just came straight down, you know, that road and been a little bit better off, but you go right ahead, dude. guess I don't need to turn left here. Shouldn't, you know, be using my Jake brake in the city, but I missed my freaking turn back there. Dadgummit. God. Let's do a big old U-turn here and get going back in the right direction. Not a big deal at all. Just like that, we're right back on track. So how close are we now? Not much closer than we were before. But there is a little rest stop over here. I think we're going to hit that. And then we'll wrap it up there. I don't know, I just hate driving through the cities like this to get back out on the interstate. Makes absolutely no sense to me why they would design it like that. You know, I know there are some instances where you have to drive through a city, or where you can drive through a city to, you know, kind of gain a little bit of time in some very rare cases. But those are pretty few and far between. Is this taking me to the rest stop or nope? Oh, there's one right up ahead here, though. We'll X off of that guy. Mark that. How's that? How about that? This is probably a better rest area to stop, or rest place to stop at anyway. This is a pretty big, wide open, you know, gravel parking lot, so works out pretty good, I guess. we go. Get all turned around here and should be good. All right, guys, that's going to wrap it up for another episode of Stories from the Road. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a like and a share. It just helps me out a bunch, helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please consider doing so now. But guys, until the next episode, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing you. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing. Also, if you want to follow me over on the Twitters, follow the link down in the video description. And if you're looking for great gaming gear at an affordable price, then be sure to check out my No Scope Gaming Glasses affiliate link, also down in the video description. And lastly, I upload 3 days a week, so be sure to check down below for my various content playlists for any videos you may have missed. Until the next video, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing ya.